Let's talk about the relationship between your gut bacteria and viruses. Now, in your gut, you have something called the microbiome, okay? I don't know if you knew this, but that's a combination of not just friendly bacteria, but you also have yeast in there, you have parasites, you have even candida, and viruses. Yeah, I know. There's something called VLP, viral-like particles, and you have a lot of these in and around your body. Now, the VLPs are non-infective. They don't have any genetics inside the cell, but they're viral-like particles that exist throughout the body. There's not a lot of things known about them, but they're doing research on them. Now, I don't want to alarm you or freak you out, but there's something called the human gut virome, which are clusters of viruses that live in your body. And there's a lot of them. I mean, think about how many bacteria you have. You have like trillions. Well, these viruses outnumber your bacteria by 10 to 1 and sometimes 20 to 1. Now, these viruses coexist, and many times they don't create any problem unless you have some lowered resistance or some medical problem where you become susceptible and then they start to create problems. But you do have a lot of viruses living in your body already. And this is why it is so important to keep your immune system very, very strong, something they don't talk about on the news. And you do have sitting in the background this army of immune cells, not just white blood cells, but the microbiome, the good bacteria, are part of your immune system. And I want to talk about some of the things that they do related to keeping your immune system strong. If you're lacking good bacteria, maybe you took antibiotics or something, the bad bacteria can then thrive. And also, if you're eating foods that stimulate inflammation, the inflammation alone will create a shift from good bacteria to bad bacteria, and you lose the diversity of friendly bacteria. But this good bacteria, called the microbiome, helps maintain the integrity of the intestinal barrier. So picture this. You have this large intestine, and you have this mucus layer on both sides, okay? And then right across this intestines, you have this lymph layer. It's like lymph tissue, and you have a lot of white blood cells and immune cells through here. So you have this protective mucus layer, and then you have the good bacteria right here, and a lot of the pathogens and viruses live throughout here as well. So one of the key things is keeping these bacteria working to create this wall to prevent the bad guys from going across the wall inside your body. So this is your immigration, okay? You have to get the stamp of approval. You have to have a good passport to have access inside. So this is a protective defense mechanism. So you have good bacteria and your white blood cells helping you in defending against the pathogens. So the good bacteria help maintain the integrity of the intestinal barrier. They also keep the inflammation in check. So that's important. They also compete for space and food. So they don't let the unfriendly bacteria have enough space to live or enough food, because there are so many of these good bacteria. They just basically compete for space and food. That's one of their strategies. And they inhibit pathogens by these two mechanisms, as well as many other antimicrobial defenses. They have the ability to directly kill pathogens. They also help enhance your immune system. When they eat fiber from vegetables, for example, they make short-chain fatty acids, and these alone can help reduce inflammation and support your immune system. Also, one of the names of these short-chain fatty acids is called butyrate, and that is a really good anti-inflammatory. It helps blood sugars, and it actually feeds your colon cells. So these microbes make food for your cells. Now, there's also a crosstalk or a link between the microbes in your gut and your respiratory tract. If you think about these microbes, and they're in the trillions, they live not just inside, but they live outside. They live in your lung. They help protect things. So there's definitely communication going on through the entire body. There's even communication going on from your microbes to the colon cells. So there's a lot of coordination in the immune system. And you don't have a strong integrity of your good bacteria, you're very susceptible to getting all sorts of pathogens and infections. Also, the bile salts, which are recycled and modified by your friendly bacteria, are antibacterial. And also, the microbiome has antiviral properties as well. One thing you need to realize is a lot of these pathogens love sugar, especially candida. So that would be something very easy to avoid to keep your immune system strong. Also, you want to replenish the friendly bacteria sometime. And this is why I always recommend periodic probiotics to keep the good bacteria at a high level. Also, the prebiotic, that's your fiber. These microbes love fiber. If you consume a good amount of vegetable every day, you can feed them the food that they thrive on. And if you haven't seen my comprehensive digestive video, it's very, very simple, but it's very comprehensive. I put it right here. Check it out.